बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू। दिस इज़ योर बायोलॉजी क्लास और रेज़ योर हैंड फॉर दुआ। बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम, रब्बी शराली सदरी व यस्सिर ली अमरी वाहलुल उक़दतम बिल लिसानी यफ़क़हु कौली, रब्बी ज़िदनी इल्मा, रब्बी यस्सिर व ला तुय्यसिर व तम्मिम बिल खैर। स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो दैट अल्लाह हैज़ गिवन अस अ लॉट ऑफ ब्लेसिंग्स। इफ़ वी सी आवर डेली डाइट, वी ईट अ लॉट ऑफ ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ अल्लाह इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रूट्स, वेजिटेबल, pulses, grains. So today we are going to discuss about the nutrients. Nutrients are basically the chemicals that are present in the food. They may be protein, fats, carbohydrates. Question arises that why do we need food? We need food because it provides us energy. It is needed for growth. It is used to repair the worn off tissues and cells, and it keeps us healthy, and it also prevents us from the different type of diseases. Our 70% of the body's weight is because of water. So water is very essential in life. It is an essential part of protoplasm, lubricants, digestive juices and blood, and it is a medium for chemical reactions that are taking place in the body. It helps to control the body temperature, and it transports the food substances from one part of body to another, and also excretory products and the hormones as well. In plants, water is needed for photosynthesis. It is used to transport water and food through the xylem and phloem tissues, and it helps the cell to keep firm and turgid. How much water do we need depends upon these three factors, like how active a person is. If he is a sportsman and he is involved more in the physical activities, he needs more water as compared to the other person. And if a person is, how healthy is the person is, like if the person is suffering from the diabetes, he or she needs more water as more urine passes in this disease. Then by mental condition, if a person is living in a dry and hot condition, he needs more water as compared to the person living in the temperate climate. Carbohydrate is a nutrient. There is a classification of carbohydrates like simple and complex. Simple carbohydrates are comprised of monosaccharide and disaccharide, and complex one have the polysaccharides. Maltose, sucrose and lactose are the double sugars, and the simple molecules combine together to form the bigger molecules with the removal of water, and this process is called condensation. And the complex molecules are broken down to the simple molecules with the addition of water molecules. This is called as hydrolysis. These are the complex sugars like starch, glycogen and cellulose, and the occurrence is also shown. Like starch is a storage form of carbohydrate in plants, and glycogen is a storage form of carbohydrate in animals, and it is mainly present in liver and muscles. Cellulose is a structural form of carbohydrates in plants, as you have read that plant cell wall is composed of cellulose. Now there are the few functions of carbohydrates mentioned here, like it provides the energy for cell activities. It is required for the formation of nucleic acid like DNA, and it is also required to make the nectar in some of the flowers. And nectar is a sweet juice that attracts the insects towards it for pollination, and it is also requires to synthesize the lubricants as well. Next one are the fats. Fats are also the nutrients that are made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. But the proportion of oxygen is less than hydrogen as compared to the carbohydrates. Fats are present in butter, cheese, nuts, peas, white meat, palm oil, castor oil. The function of fats are here mentioned that they are the source and store energy. They act as an insulating material that prevents the excessive heat loss. For example, the animals such as seals have a thick layer of fat. They are also solvent for the fat soluble vitamins and many other substances, and they are the essential part of protoplasm, especially in cell membranes, and they are also a way to reduce the water loss from the skin surface because they form the thin layer over the skin surface, reducing the rate of evaporation of water. Proteins are made up of the carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur may also be present. They are built from the simpler compounds that are called amino acids. Amino acids are made up of the amino group, acidic group and a side chain that is denoted by R, and the general formula of the amino acids are written as like this. You can see here, this is the amino group, this is the acidic group, and this one is the side chain. Amino acids are fold to form the three-dimensional protein structure. You can see that polypeptides in turn are linked up with a longer chain of amino acids, and protein molecule is made up of one or more such chains that are folded to gather. In most protein, the polypeptide chains are folded into more complex dimensional shape. These are the sources and the function of protein. Sources are egg, milk, nuts, grains, vegetables, chicken, and lean beef. The function of the proteins are they are needed for the synthesis of new protoplasm, for the growth and repair of worn out body cell. They are needed for synthesis of enzyme and some hormones, and also for the formation of antibodies to combat the diseases. Now there is an activity time. You have to make a concept prep. You will give 1 minute presentation and you will solve the worksheet. Thank you.